One of the requirements for calibration of equipment and especially tuning radios is a accurate timing source. I picked this up on eBay a few weeks ago. I've had other sources. I also have a really old Symmetricon time source. I've got the CDMA version and the GPS version. This is a little bit more compact. It is still a teleco style unit. It has a lot of neat features. It is basically a Trimble based design. The Trimble software works with this unit. It has a really nice RS-232 jack on the front here. Basically, standard pinout connects. I connect my USB to serial converter directly up to it. It works just fine. The only thing non-standard would be the actual outputs. You can get a close in. Those are more of the MDX style connectors. Pretty easy. eBay, you can pick them up for a couple of bucks a piece and adapt those to a BNC connector. I basically got this working a few days ago. One issue that you'll find with these units from Nortel, they do have specific power requirements. Testing this unit, 28 volts will certainly supply it. It's actually designed for 48 volts power supply. And here's basically what I did to enable that. There's the actual part number. As you can see, it's actually got a Trimble marking on it. This is my modification. This is my modification. There was an existing hole. I basically just snotted this in with some hot glue and put a stress relief clamp on the back side. This is the connector. There's ample documentation online about this connector. I found it was just easier just to wire it directly in. Really simple construction. It's just a couple of screws to get this off. It exposes a single layer board underneath. And I have more of those photos of this disassembly on my blog. But this is basically it. Really simple. I paid less than $100 for the unit itself. The power supply, I actually picked that up in a bulk sale, probably for less than 10 bucks. My unit draws about 700 milliamps when you first turn it on at 48 volts. So it'll give you some idea of the current requirements. Just to kind of give you an idea of how to disassemble one of these, these are card-based units. Basically, you remove this screw behind this plate, and there's also another screw here. And that basically holds the front plate on so that you can get to this, and this will basically slide off without any issues. There is a cover plate here. This cover plate's used to basically cover these connections, and I would assume it appears that there's actually places to route wires down this direction. I'm not currently using those because I'm using this RS-232, but these are kind of short. If you do get cables, you may want to get cables that will actually bring it all the way to the edge. At some point, I will actually mount this up on the bench itself after I print out some 3D mounts for it. The distribution amp basically allows you to take this output signal. This does output 10 megahertz. It does have an even second out, which I don't use. But it basically allows you to take that 10 megahertz out and distribute it across your equipment. A couple of places that I'm using it on the frequency counter. It really simple hookup in the rear. Most equipment is going to have a similar type hookup. One thing that I wanted to note is this is locked currently. It's not in holdover mode. This is able to be used with the equipment. If you'll notice, there's an alarm type LED lit here. This basically comes on because this is expecting to talk to something, more likely a phone switch or what have you. And because we're not sending those commands, it doesn't, it will actually alarm. The alarm itself, some folks have been able to rectify it. They actually have it talking to something. At one point I looked at actually getting a connector for the rear and actually putting some type of embedded device against this. I haven't done that yet, but like I say, this is not a symptom of doom. This is basically just letting you know that it sees an issue, that it can't talk to a piece of equipment it thinks is supposed to be there.